All right, now that we've got our dimension style set up, we've got arc 48 set current here. Previous video, we set that all up. Now what we're going to do is we're going to put the dimensions into the project. I have a picture of what it's going to look like here, straight out of your book. We're just going to put all these dimensions in here. This is really not going to take very much time at all. I'm going to show you a couple of tips and tricks as we go, and kind of walk you through how I do it. So first of all, we got to set up our own brand new layer. So I'm going to go to layer properties here. Here's all the layers that I have. I need a dimension layer, so I'm going to create a dimension layer. Call it dimension. Color really doesn't matter as long as you're using one of these index colors. So let's go with, I don't know, green. Let's go with red. I haven't used red in this drawing yet. So that's good. We want our line type to be continuous. Make sure that it does not have a dash to it. And we want our line weight to be default. We don't want big, thick, bold dimensions. The next thing that we're going to do, and I don't think the book asks you to do this, but this is how I do it. I create a dimension offset layer. And let's change the color. I like that to be, for some reason, it's like a construction line. I always do construction lines yellow. You've probably heard me say that before. I'm going to set that one current. And I'll show you what I do here. So I'm going to come over here. I've got my dimension offset layer set current. I'm going to come over here and draw a rectangle. And I'm just going to trace over my walls. There we go. Just drew a rectangle straight up. So my dimension offset, it tells me in the book that my dimension offset is supposed to be 27 inches for the first row of dimensions and then 18 inches for each additional row of dimensions. So I'm going to come over here. I'm going to do an offset 27 inches. I'm going to take my new line, offset it out. I'm going to press enter to end that command. Press enter to start it again. We'll do 18 inches. And there's my construction lines for where these dimensions need to go in here. So now what I'm going to do is set my dimension layer current. Very good. We're going to go to annotate. And I'm going to put my first dimension down. And so this is going to be a linear dimension. I'll show you what I'm going to do here. I'm going to start up in this top corner, take it from the edge to the center of the window. Notice that this one has the window marker kind of off to the side, and the dimension is going straight down to the window. However, my drawing has the window marker perfectly centered. Two ways that you can do it. I will do it both ways so that you see. I'm going to do a linear dimension. Click here. If you were to go to the center of the window, notice my dimensions are coming out beautifully. If I go through the center of the window, I can't cover up that B. I need to be able to read it clearly. So if your B, if your window marker, oops, I'm going to move this out of the way. If yours was off to the side, that's perfect. That's what you saw in the book. Mine, though, was perfectly centered. And so what I'm going to do is instead of going through the B, I'm going to bring it up to that top quadrant. Make sure that dimension didn't change, because if it changed, then your window marker was not perfectly in the center. But that way, you're coming out to the window marker, which is centered on the window. Two totally acceptable ways to do it however you see it. From here, I could do another linear, and then I can click on this dimension, and then I can click on that wall. But look what I can do. I've already got my first linear dimension here. I'm just going to say continue. It picks up where that one left off. I'm going to come over here, snap to the left side of that wall, the inside of the bathroom, and then I'm going to snap here. Look how easy that was. You just started with your first dimension, and you just kind of went from there. So, let's see, I'm going to try to show you a really cool trick that I don't know if it's going to work. I'm going to do a linear dimension. If I press enter right here, when you first start a linear dimension and then you click on a line, look at this. Oh, how cool is that? If you start the dimension, press enter in the beginning, and then you click on the line, it finds the endpoints of that line. So I didn't have to click endpoint to endpoint. It found the endpoints of the line. When you do that, you got to make sure that you're really grabbing the correct line, and you got to make sure that the dimension comes out correctly. So mine did. It's 18. Just a little trick. It's a cool thing to know in AutoCAD now that we're experts at dimensioning after chapter 5. Show you little tips and tricks like that. All right, we got another linear dimension. I'll just come over here to this edge. This one comes to the inside of the closet this time. Bring it out here, and then we'll say continue, and just click right here. Let's see if we can do it again. Linear, press enter, click on, whoops, that edge, bring it out, 15, like a rock star. Linear, click on this edge. Gotta be careful not to get the wrong point there. We're gonna bring it to the quadrant if you have it there, or the center of the window. Make sure that it really comes out to 2'6". And then I'm gonna continue. My quadrants seem to be working here, here. I need to get to the middle of that door, but I don't have anywhere to snap for the middle of that door. So I'm gonna do a, shift right click, mid between two points. I love this command. When you do that now, I'm gonna click at the end point here and click at the end point there. And look, it just went right in between the two places that I clicked. Last one here. So make sure these come out correctly. It needs to be 2'8", 4'6", 4'2", 4'2", 2'6". Do another linear. We'll just be fancy and do this all the way across. There we go, looking good. And last side, linear. Doesn't matter really where you start. I'm gonna go from here to here. Make sure they come out correctly. Continue. There are no fractions in this one, so if you see a fraction, stop and check it out. See where that fraction came from. So easy peasy. This just, everything is spaced evenly. The only other dimensions that we need to do are over here in the closet. So I've got all of the outer dimensions taken care of here. I'm going to go into the closet. I have my shelf is 1 foot, and I have from the edge of the wall, the inside of the wall, to the center of my door is 3'4". So I will just do two more dimensions over here. Linear, edge of the wall to the shelf. 1 foot, if this looks okay, if it doesn't, you feel like it, you know, you can't read it, you want to make sure you can clearly read all the text. So you can pull that text out there, just grabbing the grips. Next up, linear, we're going to come over here and we're going to shift right click like we did before, mid between 2 points. And we're gonna go, oops, there's endpoint, to endpoint. There we go, 3'4", looking good. Looking at this, I did notice my wall thickness note is a little close, so I'm just gonna move that out of the way a little bit. All right, this looks great. The only other thing that I have to do now is come over here. That offset dimension offset command or layer was helpful, but I don't actually want to see it. So now that I'm done with it, I'm going to turn that layer off. I can't see it. It just helped me line everything up quickly so that everything was perfectly spaced in all the views. And this looks great. Go ahead and save your work, and you are done dimensioning the guest cottage.